Yo, Johnny, I am so sorry about Last Battle, man. I should have had him. Sorry ain't gonna cut it. See, first, you lost the Battle Tag Team Championships to Valuables at Omega. It was supposed to be your crowning moment, and you lost it. And then, Extreme Mania, you were not there for Savage when he got pinned. And you lost the tag titles again at the grandest stage. It was supposed to be our most dominant moment. And now, you lose to a guy you've beaten twice already? My ice is skating on. It's getting real thin here, E.
Man, bro, chill.
First of all, I ain't your bro. I'm your boss. Now hit the showers and go home. You're not booked. Now.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Battle. I'm your commentator for tonight, Stephen Matthews. And we're about to get into the thick of the action, because we're getting things started with the first match of the night, as we got the Irish Ayatollah, MD, facing Dark Lucha. And here's MD about to make his way to the ring. There he is. MD, who, ever since he came back, started back from the roots, started from Evolve. Then he was drafted to battle by Johnny, our general manager, by Johnny D. He was drafted to battle. He went into the battle showcase at Extreme Mania, but unfortunately, he fell short. I mean, he had those moments. He was so close to win that showcase. He was so close get that big win or that big stage, but unfortunately he failed short. But tonight is the chance for him to redeem himself.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring from Belfast, Northern Ireland, weighing in at 229 pounds, MD.
MD, baby. MD. Well, I said it so many times, I know this man so personally, so very well, because I have commentated so many matches of this man's career, and I know what he's all about. And tonight, Dark Lucha has a huge tool pulled on him to beat this man. He has a huge obstacle on MD, because MD is no slouch, I have to say. But here's this man, Dark Lucha, who I've been told, and he's a former Triple Crown champion and a former Intercontinental champion. Dark Lucha, who held those titles at the same time, both of them, the Intercontinental Championship from Fight and the Evolve Championship, Evolve Triple Crown Championship from Evolve. Dark Lucha, who made his return at the World Rumble 2 months ago. And we haven't seen him since, but you know, tonight he's here, he's back. And he has a big match ahead of him against MD, like I said. Man, cannot wait. I mean, it's been so long since we've seen Dark Lucha in a singles competition, in a match, in a singles competition. And he's about to get down. Both of them focus on their eyes. Here we go, MD out of the blue, oh! Trying to go for something, but Dark Lucha had it well scouted, gets caught in the sling blade, MD is, and a nice drop kick, basement drop kick to the head. Now, oh, no, Dark Lucha took too much time to show about, and they might cost him, but no, MD thought he had the upper advantage, oh! Nice cold breaker there from Dark Lucha, and a kick to the face. I mean, I did say he's gonna be a difficult task for Dark Lucha to beat MD, but you know, I mean, so far he's having the control over him. Dark Lucha, I previously mentioned, a double champion in Zona. Oh my god, what a move, what a nice popcorn hello from Dark Lucha. Now on the outside, the referee's kind of is at two now and dominating on MD with those drop kicks, and now just working on that arm is Dark Lucha. Oh, look at him. Look at this. Oh my god. Dark Lucha with those educated fists. Oh, MD finally gets out of it. Oh, and just tosses Lucha. Oh, into the barricade. What a straight fist to the face. Oh, and MD. Oh, man, what a fool to the face. And I think, I'm not sure because I cannot see because of the mask, but I think if you would have not had that mask, I think you would have most likely been busted open. Referee's count is at 7. MD will take a count up win. I mean, a win is a win nonetheless, but not like this. Dark Lucha. Oh my god, and 9. Dark Lucha came back into the ring. Thankfully, oh, and the match still continues. Oh, but MD now having those knees for that back of Lucha. Very well scouted. MD. Oh, what a move there. What a fireman's carries drop, I think. I don't even know what to call that move. Oh, man. Oh, MD. Oh. MD gets caught to the world. Oh, dying the Fujiwara by Dark Lucha. But MD having the wherewithal to get out of it very quickly, and now has the control over again over Dark Lucha, putting him into the ropes. Wait, oh, sending it to the outside with that forearm. MD's about to take flight, and he does through the bottom rope. Over the bottom rope, sorry, my mistake. Man, what a move though. What a nice suicide forearm, I might have to call it. Oh my god. Nope. MD gets caught with that nice little barrel DDT. Man, spiked him on that floor. The ref's counts at 4. Dark Lucha stalking MD. MD! Oh, the baseball slide. Now MD just showboating himself. Showboating him as well. Oh, he's sending Dark Lucha to the outside again. What is he thinking, though? What is MD thinking? Oh, never mind. He goes after Lucha, but it's too late. Oh, backstabber. That was the backstabber by Dark Lucha. And now sending MD into the guardrail there. Oh, and now just a nice forearm, nice elbow, I have to say, maybe, to the face. Oh, and MD with the, oh, gets caught there by Dark Lucha. Nice move there. Oh, what a kick to the face. No, roundhouse. An atomic drop. Look at this combination of Endeavor. Head scissors again. And tossing MD. Oh, now Dark Lucha will take the count out win. No, he won't. Dark Lucha, he's not built this way. This man wants to do it the right way, the honorable way. He wants to win by pinfall or submission. This man, like I said, he has his, I don't even know how to say it. Oh! Has his own mindset. He knew he would not take that count out win. I mean, most likely MD would have not got out until the count of 10. And Dark Lucha realized that, and he wants to do it the right way. Oh, and then he gets caught with a cold ramp on the outside, on that ramp, steel ramp. The referee's count is at 8. Oh no, MD's not gonna make it. MD, count of 9, MD. Oh, he gets back. Dark Lucha waiting him, though. He was waiting for him, MD gets caught. No, he doesn't. DDT, oh, the move goes for the cover, hook the leg, only one count. Still gonna take a lot more than that to put down MD. Not gonna lie, I thought that was the end. I thought MD's done, and the ref is at 9. What is MD thinking? Oh, nice springboard kick to the face. MD about to take flight again. Nice diving elbow. Hook delay, cover 1, 2, and a 3, and that's it. That's it. MD has picked up the win.
Here is your winner, MD.
We thought it was the end when he was on that ramp at 9. We thought it was over, but MD persevered and went through, and he won. Wow, man, what a crazy way to start things off with that match between Dark Lucha and MD. Great showing between those two men, but we're getting things only started. We got our second match.
One fall, making his way to the ring from Cleveland, Ohio, weighing in at 275 pounds, the Savage.
Here he is, this big man, this mountain of a man in Savage, as he's facing a man who's been very vocal about taking down the TDC and Xander Wolf. You know, the thing is, Savage and Youngblood, the TDC, hasn't been doing very well as of late. I mean, they've lost the tag team championships at Extreme Mania to the Apocalypse. And that was mentioned earlier by Johnny. He was upset with the fact that these two, not only that they lost the titles once at Omega, the Valuables, they also lost them again at Extreme Mania, the Apocalypse. There was supposed to be their crowning moment, and Johnny's been very upset with both of these men, with Youngblood and Savage, my mistake. But tonight, Johnny said it himself, I don't care. I mean, Youngblood, yeah, he lost to Hendry on the last episode, but that was then. This is now. We got Savage facing Xander Wolf.
Connecticut.
The thing is, these two men right here are about to go throw hands. Xander Wolf, ever since Road to Glory, after Road to Glory, he tried his best to get his soul run. He was upset with Hendry because it was just a little bit of a
move. From Hartford, Connecticut, weighing in at 225 pounds,
because Johnny said earlier that Youngblood was not there for Savage at Extreme Mania when he was pinned. Same thing with Hendry with Wolf. Wolf was pinned at Road to Glory. Hendry could have stopped it, but he didn't. Wolf got upset with that. And ever since then, he started his own trajectory. He started his own rise to the top as a singles competitor. And I have to say, he's been doing a pretty damn good job. I mean, think about it. He nearly came close to be at Extreme Mania in the Battle Showcase. He beat MD before that, and now he has the chance to beat this man in Savage, but it's gonna be a big task. I previously mentioned it's a big task. Here it go, Savage. Oh, and out of nowhere already with that lariat, sending Wolf into the corner and just stomping a mud hole in him. You know, Wolf has been very vocal. He wants to take every single member of the TDC down until he reaches Johnny, and then his mission will be complete, as he put it in his own way. But I don't think he really thought this through. I mean, he's facing a big man. He's Savage, and you know, oh my God, look at this. It's Savage dominating. Oh my God. I mean, he's not like crazy big, but he's big in his own right. He's tall. Oh, Wolf. The voice disaster. That leg drop could have been the end already. Wolf with that brain buster. Xander Wolf connects the brain buster on Savage. The raw power of Xander Wolf. Look at this. Nice move. And now Xander getting back into it. I mean, like I said, the TDC and Bold Legacy and the TDC, for a matter of fact, have been having their own issues. Their own agendas, you know. I mean, I said it. TDC have had the worst of luck since Extreme Mania. Last episode, Youngblood has faced this man's former partner in James Hendry and lost. And now, tonight, Savage has to face Xander to prove himself Johnny, apparently. That's what Johnny said. Youngblood. Oh! And now, we got this fight. I mean, you know. Oh! Out of the blue, Xander said he wants every single person of the TDC, and he wants to take every single person down. One goes to the cover. Two on Savage. And like I said, Xander's doing this alone. He didn't think this through, because it's gonna be one of the toughest matches of his career tonight against Savage. Oh, and look at this once again. Now Xander with those educated fist strikes that Xander does to Savage. Oh, nice. Oh, gets caught. Oh, what a chop from Savage. And now Xander with a kick to the gut. Reversed it, and he now has control for a bit until crazy with those back elbows, the gut. And now he's taking him, Xander with the double leg takedown there and those strikes. Xander tried his best to cover up, but I think most of them connected. And now crazy goes to the outside. What is he doing? Look at this. Oh, nice move there. A tequila sunrise having on Xander, but it's not gonna do much effect, especially even if Xander tapped out, it's on the outside, so it doesn't count. Gotta do that in the ring. And now Xander tosses Savage into the barricade. Xander goes back into the ring, and look at this. Xander taunting in front of Savage, playing with him, mind game, those mind games from Xander, no way. Brainbuster once again. Spiked him on the mat. Goes for the cover. Oh, only a one count. Barely a one. Xander Wolf. It's the control at this point. Look at him. Oh, can't get. Oh, lethal combination. Man, Xander. Oh. Xander. Fisherman. Buster. Hook delay. Goes for the cover. One. Two. But only a two count for Xander Wolf. But that was a close one. That was a close one, I have to say. Xander most likely would have gone for that double underneath face buster or the Koji clutch. Oh, and crazy. Savage. My mistake. Savage back with those nice super kick. Got back with that offensive move. And now goes for a cover on Xander Wolf. But Xander grabbing the ropes. It's a rope break. I don't know if it would have been the end, but most likely the rope saved Wolf from an eventual defeat. And another super kick, but this time to the gut. Savage. Look at him now. He has once again the control over Xander. You know, that's the thing. I mean, Savage has the height advantage, the strength advantage on Xander. I don't know if I can say the speed advantage though, but he has more advantages on him than Wolf has on Savage. And look at this! Oh, he was going for a drop kick into the corner, but Xander had to wear it all and reversed it, got out of it. And whoa! Look at this. Xander with a nice takedown. Now Xander. Wait. Not. Oh, nice knee to the gut, taking down the tree known as Savage. No way. No way. Oh, underhook suplex. Scott is going for that underhook face buster. No, he wasn't. DDT maybe, most likely, but no. Gets reversed by Crazy. Oh, look at Crazy. Oh! My Savage, my mistake. I keep misspelling the names. Oh, look at this now. Oh, Savage goes up. Look at this. Oh! Those kicks and now taking down Xander once again. Goes for the cover. Two. Oh, but only a two count. Only a two count for Savage. But he's getting there. He's getting closer to that three. Only needs to do a big move and most likely will be the end. Oh. Nice picture perfect neck breaker from Savage on Xander. Xander rolling to the outside. I think that was the only thing he could have done. Oh no. Get some air. Getting a little break from Savage. Oh, look at Savage with a suplex onto the outside. That must hurt. You know, even though there's padding on the outside, it still hurts. Oh, Xander! Oh! He capitalized on the fact that Savage tried to do a knee drop and landed awkwardly on that knee. Xander took advantage of that. I mean, he has to do that. I mean, in all fairness, Savage is a big dude and gotta take every advantage you can against this kind of a man, this kind of monster in Savage. Oh, and Xander, another underhook suplex. And another takedown, another belly-to-belly takedown. And a kick to the back. Now once again with another kick. I think Xander was trying to do, and he may do, he may do. Here he goes. Double underhook, new face buster. I think it's the end. One, two. Oh, not enough. Not enough to put down Savage. Not yet. Savage, no, you can like him or hate him, but Savage is one tough dude. And he showed that tonight. He took that move. And we all thought it was the end. But Xander is not gonna let down. He's just gonna keep on. He's just gonna keep on the assault. He's gonna keep on beating Savage until he gets that elusive win. Oh! But that's the same thing Savage will do. I mean, Savage is trying his best to get back into the good graces of Johnny in the Davenport clan. Oh no, he gets caught. Fisherman Buster! I think Xander knows he just can't do one big move. He gotta do two or more moves on Savage to get the job done. I think he may do it. He may. He's going it for it again. Fisherman Buster. And now, once again, connected that underhook double E face buster. Two. And yeah, that's the end. Xander Wolf with a big win, literally big win over Savage tonight. Xander Wolf. And I don't think Johnny will like that, I have to say. I don't think Johnny's very happy now because Xander pulled off the upset, pulled off the win. Man, but what a match and what a way to end it. Xander Wolf does good on his promise and he takes down Savage.
You too, huh?
What you mean?
It means that like E, you disappointed the fan. You lost to Wolf, some you've already beaten. And now, as general manager, I'm obligated to give Legacy the tag team title match next week against Apocalypse instead of y'all. And it's no one's fault but your own.
What? Man, this is bullshit.
Y'all had the chance. E could have beaten James Hendry. You could have beaten Xander Wolf. But now because you both lost, both those two who were not even a tag team up until now, they get to reunite. and get a shot at the Battle Tag Team Championships. And y'all get to go home and think about how you can better represent this family. We clear?
Crystal. Good thing I already know how to fix it.
Man, I don't know what to say. I mean, Johnny has just been belating his family. I mean, talking like this to family.
The following is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring from Wolverhampton, England, weighing in at 228 pounds, Nathan Hunter.
Us, you know, we gotta move forward. I mean, we got our main event tonight. We got this man right here, Nathan Thunder. And I gotta be honest with y'all. I'm so impressed by this man. He is, ever since he made his debut in Evolve, I think I called his first match. He won that battle. No, sorry, my mistake. Evolve Battle Royal. When him and MD were the last two. And he won that match. He eliminated four people in that night. He went to the Rumble. Was in the final four. A man like him who was drafted to a battle by Johnny T, by our gentleman, Johnny T. He went to be in the final four. That's something. That's quite an accomplishment to be in the final four of the Royal Rumble match. He went to the Extreme Mania Battle Showcase, but unfortunately he didn't win. And tonight, tonight he has the biggest match of his career yet. And most likely the match he might have to regret the most having. Because he's facing a man, and that's not even, I don't even know if I can call that person a man. The entity that is Reaper Killer. He's facing a monster in Reaper Killer. And I'm not seeing a very good outcome after this match for Nathan Thunder. I do believe in this kid sometimes, and I believe he has a chance to at least survive the onslaught that's about to come in his way from this entity, from this vicious, vicious entity. A man I'm so afraid to even mention at times, let alone see him. Reaper Killer, who last episode made his intentions clear. He wants the World Heavyweight Championship. Reaper Killer, who ever since the Rumble, he hasn't been doing what he should have done. He went into the Royal Rumble match at number one, and he lasted a very good amount of time. I think somewhere nearly the 30-minute mark. But you know what? He did hang in. He got himself eliminations. He hung in there. He went into Extreme Mania in that match alongside Amy Reed against Dottie and Jester. And he prevailed alongside Amy. And last episode I mentioned, he took out our general manager, the world champion, Johnny, that sight. And tonight, he has his match against Nathan Thunder. But we all know what is on the mind of Reaper Killer. And that's not only to hurt every single person going on his way, not to hurt Johnny. He wants to capture the one thing that will give him power in this kingdom, and those are the keys to the kingdom, those keys being the World Heavyweight Championship. His brothers, as he likes to call them, his family in War and Santos Fox, they already won the tag team championships at Extreme Mania. They only need one more piece of the puzzle, and that missing piece is the World Championship, and that's what Reaper Killer is trying to put. That was what Reaper Killer trying to find. That piece, that final missing piece of the puzzle, which is the title that he has been trying to win for so long. The 1000 is constantly eluding him. And tonight, it could be one step forward for Reaper Killer to go face Johnny for that title eventually. Here we go, the bell has rung. And Reaper Killer now trying to get the momentum, but look at Thunder. Had to wear it all, but now it gets caught. And once again, Thunder is not gonna go down that easy. Only the match just begun. Oh, look at this, Thunder! Look at this, the Athleticism of the King! What is Thunder gonna do? Nice, whoa! What a man, what a move, I gotta say. Nice offensive move from Thunder, sending Reaper Killer to the outside, then doing a head scissors. Man, what a move, and oh! Reaper Killer gets back with that DDT onto the outside floor, and now Killer, Reaper Killer getting back into it. Oh, but he gets caught, a Spanish Fly on his way back into the ring. And now Thunder, kick to the gut, working on the arm. What is he doing? He has the control. Look at this, using the ropes as leverage, and look at this, nice arm drag. Man, oh, look at those kicks, vicious kicks to the face, and now working on the legs, Nathan Thunder. And now Thunder sending Reaper Killer into the ropes, into the corner. And now look at those kicks to the leg, and what is he doing? Most likely a tornado DDT. Nice move. Goes for the cover, hook the leg on Reaper Killer. Only a one count. Oh, tried to thump his head into the mat. No. Reaper Killer get out of it. Now Hang has the control, sending Nathan into the ropes, getting a back elbow for his troubles. Kip up. Oh, oh, got in the guillotine. The ref is there to check if Thunder's gonna pass out or not, or tap out. No, gets out of it. Nice way to get out of it. Very innovative. Oh, and look at those roundhouse kick. Gets caught. Kick to the shin of Thunder. And now Hang with the power slam, most likely. No! Snake Eyes into the ropes. Now look at this. Choking Nathan Thunder onto the ground. Choking the life out of him. Oh, and now a Senton. Diving Senton. And look at this. Mind games. Those sick, sick mind games from Reaper Killers. Just sitting beside Nathan Thunder. And Thunder is not going to take lightly to that. Or... And look at this. Those strikes and the punch. Lariat. Another lariat, trying to get back into it, into the ropes. Nice drop kick. Thunder feeling it. I mean, just imagine if he can pull this off. Oh man, what a kick to the face. Oh no, Reaper Killer. Test press, and look at this punch. Oh man. Oh no, I think he actually busted Nathan Thunder open and sending it over the rope to that lariat. I think Thunder is bleeding, but Reaper Killer gets caught with the code breaker. But it's Thunder, working on that leg. Nice idea. Having to wear it all to work on those limbs. You gotta do that. Taking Reaper Killer down limb by limb. Especially working on those legs. I mean, Reaper Killer in his own right is a big dude. Oh, and Reaper Killer now gets back. Oh no, he gotta do it! Sight! The sight! On Nathan Thunder, 2, 3, that's it. I mean, Nate, gotta give it to Nathan Thunder. He put up the fight. He indeed did put the fight. He has brought the fight, but unfortunately was not enough. It was not enough. Reaper Killer won, and he's getting so close to his date to destiny. Wait, Johnny! Whoa! Where did he go? Johnny said the fact he was trying to get one up on Reaper Killer, but Reaper Killer was smart. But that was all the time we got. See you next time.
Wait. Who in here trying to start a fight?